Close sports polls. USA Today sports Sam Amick tells us what he's hearing about whether the reeling Thunder want to move Paul George before the trade deadline. USA Today sports. Celtics forward Jason Tatum signals after making a three-pointer against the Nuggets during the second quarter at TD Garden in Boston. Photo. Winslow Townsend. USA Today sports. Boston. AP. The Celtics expected to have their hands full with a Nuggets team that has had no trouble putting the ball in the basket this season. Boston countered by having its best shooting night of the season. Kyrie Irving had 33 points and the Boston Celtics held on for a 124-118 victory over the Denver Nuggets on Wednesday night. Irving added 7 assists. It was his 8th game this season with 30 or more points. Jaylen Brown finished with 26 points and 5 rebounds. The Celtics improved to 13-2 at home this season. We had to be resilient practically the whole night and kind of weather their storms. Irving said, they kept coming and kept coming. We had to outscore them at some point. Quote, box score, Celtics 124, Nuggets 118. The 124 points was a season high for Boston. The Celtics shot a season high 60% from the field. There were 8 ties and 6 lead changes. But Boston never surrendered the lead in the second half. That was the only way we were going to win tonight, the way we were guarding and rebounding. Coach Brad Stevens said, our guys distributed it well. We did cut in space well. I thought we played with good purpose and authority on offense. Quote, Gary Harris led the Nuggets with a career-high 36 points and 6 assists. Jamal Murray added 28 points and 10 assists. The Nuggets went on a 13-2 run to tie the game at 85 in the third quarter. The Boston responded in the fourth, using a 9-0 run to open a 106-94 lead. Denver's Nikola Jokic sat out his 7th straight game with a left ankle sprain. Celtics forward Al Horford had the night off to rest a right knee bruise. Tip-ins. Nuggets. Will Barton sat out with a lower back bruise. Denver connected on their first 7 field goal attempts. Celtics. Shane Larkin had 14 points off the bench. Denver's 118 points was an opponent's season high. Boston has made 10 or more three-pointers in 11 straight games. Marcus Morris sat out for the 4th time in 5 games rehabbing his left knee. Quotable. We came out shorthanded back-to-back. But that's not an excuse and had great energy. That's all you can ask. It's been a long road trip and now we can go back and defend home court. Harris. Bye-bye goggles. For now, Brown is done with his goggles. He wore contacts Wednesday for the first time since accidentally scratching his cornea. He had been playing with protective goggles for 3 games, but he said the 2 versions he'd been using both had issues. One pair was fogging up too easily. The other started to become a hindrance and fit too tightly on his face, obstructing his peripheral vision. It's just uncomfortable with them. So I decided I was better off without them. He said, doctors say he can wear his contacts for a few hours the next couple of days. The change even brought about a post-game joke from Stevens. We had some laughs in retrospect about that. Retrospect about that. Stevens said, I said, retrospect. I've been thinking about that all week. Quote, first step. Wednesday marked a milestone in Gordon Hayward's recovery process from his broken left ankle. He out of the walking boot he's been using since his surgery in October. He will continue to wear a protective brace. It's a promising step in his rehab, Stevens said, but he cautioned it's just the next one in an ongoing process. It's another box to check. There's a big difference in getting out of the boot and playing in an NBA game. Stevens said, he's got a long way to go. But it's good that he has these things as goals. He keeps checking them off and he's working really diligently at it. Quote, up next, Nuggets host Pelicans on Friday. Celtics play their fourth game in 6 days when they host the Jazz on Friday. Copyright 2017 The Associated Press. All rights reserved. This material may not be published, broadcast, rewritten or redistributed.